What the hell is the EU Digital COVID Certificate? And do you need one? I'm Kristen. Welcome to my travel channel. And today I'm going to tell you everything you really didn't want to know, but probably need to know about the EUDCC Digital COVID Certificate for travel to the EU in, about, and around the EU starting on July 1st, 2021. What is this thing anyway? So the EUDCC is basically a standardized way for citizens, residents, and foreigners alike to travel freely around the European Union. There's been a lot of talk of vaccine passports, health passports, and what the Europe Digital Green Certificate actually is not a passport at all, but it's basically a QR code that's gonna have a few important pieces of information on it. And this code can be in a digital format, in an app, or it can be printed out on paper. And all it does is it has your name, your immunization status, and your most recent PCR or rapid antigen test result. And in some cases, it might also have proof of immunity and recent recovery from COVID-19. Now, you would think that being that this is a European certificate, that there would just be one, but no, it's not that easy. Depending on which country you're from, which country you're traveling to, or which country you're currently in right now, you're going to need to get your digital green certificate from that specific country. So if you are a citizen or a resident of the EU, you can go ahead and get your local certificate from local authorities, from hospitals, from doctors. And if you are an international tourist who just wants to go to Europe for fun, then you would need to get your certificate from your country of destination. So let's say you want to go to Greece, you would need to download the Visit Greece app and then fill out their paperwork online and use Greece's digital certificate to travel to Greece. And then once you're in Greece, after you've been there for 14 days, you should be able to travel freely to other EU and Schengen countries for that matter. Now things get a little bit more complicated there because in the case of Greece, let's say you're a US tourist, you wouldn't necessarily need to show proof of vaccine in your COVID app, but you would have to have a negative PCR test. But if you were traveling from the US to France, for example, you would need to have a combination of proof of immunization and also a negative PCR test. So as you can see, it can get a little bit complicated depending on where you're from and which country you're going to. Once you have either the app or the paper with the QR code, you're gonna wanna bring that with you pretty much anywhere that you go because you might need it to get into any public or private spaces. So in Austria, for example, there's a long list of places, including museums and tourist sites, that they might be asking to scan that code when you get there. So the idea is that regardless of which country you get this app or paper from, all the other countries will accept it. And they're even working on something between the UK and the EU so that if you get your UK digital COVID certificate through the NHS, for example, that can also be recognized in the European bloc. Another question that people have had is which vaccines will be approved. And here's where it gets complicated again. So the European Commission has said that at a minimum, it will be the 4 EU approved vaccines. So that's Pfizer, Moderna, AstraZeneca, and Johnson & Johnson. But countries can decide to accept other vaccines as well. So this can be the Russian Sputnik vaccine. Allegedly, Spain is approving 2 of the Chinese vaccines. So a lot of countries will be able to loosen those requirements. And the other good news is that countries won't be able to add more requirements. So this is basically making the standard for travel to and within Europe. So you won't need to be surprised by any extra measures like quarantines or things like that once you get there. It's also free to get it. And if you're traveling with children, then you're going to want to check on the restrictions for your destination country. So in some countries, they require that anyone over the age of 2 have a certificate. In other countries, it's 11. But otherwise, if they're traveling with a vaccinated parents or parents that have recovered in the last 6 months from COVID with a negative PCR test, then that should work too. Nice. And then is this going to be travel as we know it into the future, or is this just temporary? Well, the EU has said that they're starting with a period from July 1st until June 30th, 2022. So 1 year to start. But if the World Health Organization downgrades this COVID pandemic from a public health emergency, then it's possible that they could discontinue this in the future. But it's anyone's guess what is going to happen after that. I'm certainly not making any predictions, but at least from July 1st, 2021 through June 30th, 2022. This is all kind of a new situation and information is changing really quickly. Things are fluid. So before going anywhere, make sure you check with your airline, the destination country's government portal or tourism board. And it's also a good resource to follow these organizations on Twitter so you can get the most up-to-date information. If this video was helpful and you want me to keep doing travel updates, then give this video a like. Subscribe if you're new here and check out my Travel During Coronavirus playlist for more information on countries reopening for tourism and what you need to go there. If there's anything I forgot, comment below.